So today I show you how to replace the serpentine belt on the V6 Chrysler Jeep Grand Cherokee. We need a new belt and a 3/8 ratchet. That's all we need. Very easy. Let me place my camera here so that you can see good. And then I explain quick how this is routed. It's not easy to find a good spot. I like my GoPro Hero to do this. We have the alternator here. Then we have a tensioner, the belt tensioner. It's over there. Then we have here crankshaft. We have an idler pulley over here. Then we have our water pump there. And an AC compressor with a clutch. There we go. That's our parts. Now I go through this again quick in case you want to know again. Here, alternator, tensioner, crankshaft, idler pulley on top, water pump. Oh, there is my hand in the way. Let's try this on the other side. Water pump here, and then here on the right, the compressor clutch, the AC compressor. You see now how it runs through this engine. And then we remove the belt, we put it back on the same way. 3/8 inch long extension bar on my ratchet here. We remove the belt from the idler pulley first and then from the alternator. You saw how I pushed the tensioner to the side, to the left, to take the tension off the belt. So this we jiggle around. There. We check the length with the new belt if it's the same, so that it fits. And the number of ribs on there. Then we put it first on the crankshaft, the new one. Route it around on top over the water pump. Up and back down. Back down and then around the AC compressor. There. Make sure it fits in those little ribs. So, okay. And now we put it over here to the alternator. You see, it's over the tensioner. And then it goes around the alternator first. So, for that, we have to push our ratchet over again to get it on there easily. There, that's on. Align it a little bit. And then last step is to put it over the idler pulley on top there. And then we release the tensioner slowly. We can check it in here that it sits right. All nice and smooth. Very good. You see how it runs around. Remove our ratchet. And then we start the engine to see how that worked out. Right. It is running good. Smooth and quiet. It's fun. Now, you see the label. Alright, so this one is running really good. Now what are we doing next? Listening to it, if it makes any noise. So in this case, you hear like a whining noise, but that is a fire truck driving noise, so it's not the belt, we need to check every 60,000 miles and then replace every 90,000 miles. And as you saw, that's pretty easy. You can do it in 5 minutes if you have the tool ready. 5 minutes, you can do this on the road. So when you're done with your job here, then don't forget your tools and your packaging and the old belt. You know, you take that out before you close the hood. This, cool. Close the lid. Done. That was easy.